All right. Hello, everyone. My name is Logan Trumbo. I'm the first affirmative. For the major claim that we will be debating this evening is that terminally ill patients should have the right to physician-assisted suicide. So for those of you who do not know what physician-assisted suicide is, it is defined as involving a doctor knowingly and intentionally providing a person with the knowledge or means, or both, required to commit suicide, including counseling about lethal doses of drugs, prescribing such lethal doses, or supplying the drugs. Now, this is not to be confused with euthanasia, which is defined as the painless killing of a patient suffering from an incurable and painful disease or in an irreversible coma. The practice is illegal in most countries. So the biggest thing about physician-assisted suicide is that it is regulated. It's regulated and there's requirements. You have to be eligible. To be eligible, you must be 18 years of age, living in one of the four states that has physician-assisted suicide legalized, which is California, Washington, Oregon, and Vermont. It doesn't matter, any amount of time of being a resident there qualifies. You must be mentally competent to make your own health insurance health decisions, and you must be terminally ill and be ready to die in the next 6 months from your terminal illness to qualify. So, the significance of this problem is that people, friends, and family are suffering from a painful disease that is irreversible. The other problem that comes with this is that there are other similar forms that are legal. The goal here is to not let our loved ones suffer a slow and painful death and make all other forms of this illegal. So one of the biggest concerns that we face with the principle, or with physician-assisted suicide, is the principle of double effect. The principle of double effect means that giving pain relief treatment that also hastens death is justified, and the main intention was to relieve pain, not cause a death. Now, this is where there's much discrepancy due to it, because it goes against the ethical and moral question that people come that comes about. People believe that nobody should be able to allow to be commit suicide in any form, and there shouldn't. Doctors shouldn't be given the right to allow suicide when their main cause is to heal. So, going from there, I go into our inherency claim. We are assisting people to die, but only if they are terminally ill. According to CNN, it's legal in California, Oregon, Washington, and Vermont. And the fifth state that is it is legal in, but it has to be by a court order. Court order is Montana. There are no federal laws prohibiting physician-assisted suicide. They left it up to the states to decide this. The flaw here is that the double effect, there's no limits on how much of the pain meds are being prescribed in this situation. For the solvency claim, we say making double effect illegal so there are no accusations of homicide intentions. By doing this, we would continue to regulate the physician's assisted suicide industry while eliminating double effects, so this black market type of industry is shut down completely. There's no discrepancy whatsoever as to what decision was made and if there was any unethical decision by the physician himself. Going into the policy that we are going to propose, we would require an e-board or third party to evaluate the original doctor's diagnosis or prescription for the patient, and also have a third party evaluate the patient to confirm all doubt of their terminal illness. As of now, there is a process or procedure for anyone who's trying to obtain physician-assisted suicide. There's a first oral request where you must go speak to your physician, and they have to confirm on all levels means that the patient meets all criteria for the PAS. And they are sent from there to another physician for a second second observation to confirm the diagnosis, prognosis, and mental competence. If either physician determines that your judgment is impaired in any way by mental illness or depression, they will revoke your potential of doing so. So for the there's an overview of the physician-assisted suicide statutes. Death and dignity laws clearly outline the process by which qualified individuals obtain life-ending medication. It is up to eligible patients and their doctors to implement these laws on an individual basis. There are no government programs that will provide assistance. However, the Department of Health in each state monitors the law. Compliance protects you, your family members, and your physician from criminal prosecution. Participation in the Death and Dignity Acts is voluntarily. No one is obligated to use these laws. Thank you.